If you make short films, you absolutely will need to know how to use the end credits crawl effect in HitFilm. I'm Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei channel, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use that effect most efficiently. End credits are divided up into different sections. For example, as shown in these credits from Star Wars Episode 4, A New Hope, you see different sections for casting, sound editors, re-recording mixers, cast, etc. In HitFilm, these different sections are called elements. Opening up HitFilm Express, you can find the end credits effect in Generate, End Credits Crawl. If you create a new plane and bring that plane onto the editor timeline, then you can drag the end credits crawl effect into that plane. Like I said before, there are elements that make up your end credits crawl, and you can choose the number of elements that you want from 1 to 30. For this demonstration, I will make 5. Each element contains a title, which is, for example, producers, editors, cast, etc. The roles, or what the job of the person that did that job is, and then the names. That would be the names of the people who completed those jobs in your short film. You can, of course, change the format of each of the titles, roles, and names, changing the font, the style, the size, and you can even force those into uppercase or not. And then there are other layout changes that can be made. What I would suggest you do is create a spreadsheet with all of the information for your credits that you have in your short film. The spreadsheet that I am using is LibreOffice Calc, which is a free spreadsheet application. And in that spreadsheet application, I have all 5 of the elements in here, starting with element title 1, which is producers. And then the roles are here, along with the names of the people who fulfilled those roles. Then element title 2, and so on and so forth. What you then do is highlight the element title 1, in this case producers, and I hit Control C. Then I go to HitFilm, and under element 1, title, I go ahead and paste that, Control V. Then I can go back to my spreadsheet, highlight the roles, hit Control C to copy, and then under roles, I select this edit text icon, which brings up this edit text box. Control V to paste those information into the edit text box, clicking OK. You can see that that automatically updates in the screen. Then back in my spreadsheet, I will go ahead and highlight the names. Control C to copy. And then I will go to names, selecting the edit text box and pasting that in, Control V, and it automatically updates here. Then I would go ahead and do this with elements 2 through 5. After I have pasted all of that information into the different element sections, I can go ahead and make changes to the look and feel of this. So for example, I might go to text format and change the color to a color that I want. And then I might change the font to a different font and adjust the size of the font and force uppercase or not force uppercase. Then I would do the same for roles and for names. And it is really that simple. Now, something to understand here with the speed is that this is relative to the timing of the editor timeline, not the length. So I could change this length and it will not change where those are in the time. Only changing speed will change the timing of the end credits crawl. So if you have any questions about how to use the end credits crawl effect in your short film, leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.